Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we take a look at the updates to Microsoft Intune on Azure, with new admin experience in the Azure portal, including role-based access controls, tighter integration with Azure Active Directory, with groups and more, and lastly, reporting and automation capabilities with the Microsoft Graph API. So I'm joined by Craig Mile from the Microsoft Intune team. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, Simon.
We've been on a path to modernize Microsoft Intune for a while now. What's behind these changes?
So with Intune, we really set out to modernize how you manage apps and devices from the cloud. Mm-hmm. And as part of that journey, we realized that as you need to manage more devices across a diverse set of platforms and an ever wider range of scenarios, we really needed to modernize the service to better meet those needs. So the decision to move Intune to Azure and adopt a microservices architecture gives us a great number of advantages. We can scale to vastly increased number of devices. We can deliver features and functionality faster and deliver better resiliency, security, and availability, all while allowing you to manage the service via APIs and scripts, as well as our great new web UI.
So how do these great capabilities actually translate into what we'll see in Microsoft Intune?
So the first piece of good news is that now all of Intune management is within the Azure portal. There's no longer any need for Silverlight, and it works on virtually any browser and any device.
Fantastic.
So by way of example, I've got Intune open here in the Azure portal on my Mac, in Safari, in fact. Now, one of the great things about the portal is that I can actually create custom dashboards. So here, for example, I've created a dashboard that has tiles from Intune, Azure Active Directory, as well as some live tiles giving me information about my sign-ins from Active Directory. Now, let's say, for example, I wanted to supplement this with some information from Intune. I can switch over to one of the Intune views. Let's say I want to pick my OS distribution. I can pin that over to my Azure dashboard. And then when I navigate back, there's my information all right there, the first thing I see when I log in. Now, the other great thing is that because everything is in HTML5, you no longer need to use any additional tools to add apps to Intune. So here, for example, I can go straight into Intune, and I can add applications directly from the store. Now, because we integrate directly with these app stores, what actually happens is instead of having to type in all the information over and over, I can just perform a search straight against the store itself. So let's say, for example, I wanted to give people, I don't know, Word with Friends, because that's always a classic. I can just perform a search. It pulls right up. And with a couple of clicks, now that app is pulled directly into Intune.
So it's an easier management experience all in one place with greater visibility. And Microsoft Intune is obviously part of Enterprise Mobility and Security, or EMS for short. How are we actually going to bring all of those components together inside of the Azure portal?
So one of the great examples of how we're bringing EMS together is really around groups. So groups are now shared across Azure AD, Office 365, Microsoft Intune, and a whole bunch of other Microsoft services. If I go to Intune and I select groups, this takes me across to the Azure Active Directory blade. And this is the same list of devices and groups that I'd see across all of my services. Mm-hmm. Now, something new that we've added is the ability to do device groups. So here I have a device group that's for all iOS devices. Now, in the past, without this capability, I'd have had to add devices manually. But instead, I can actually specify rules to look for all devices with a type of iOS. And I can do simple rules, or I can do a complex rule like I've shown here, where I'm looking for all devices that are type iPhone or of type iPad. Now, anytime that a device that meets this criteria shows up in my directory, any policies and apps that I've assigned to that group will automatically apply to these devices.
So this experience is much more streamlined than it's been before, and it's completely integrated with Azure AD. Are there other examples where we're doing that kind of integration?
There are. So a great example is conditional access. So instead of before where there was Azure Active Directory and Intune places to go and configure conditional access, now it's all together in one single place. So in this example, created a policy here for Exchange Online, and I made sure that the access controls required that the user's coming in from a compliant device. So once the user gets policies from Intune and they're compliant, they'll be able to get email. If they don't, they won't.
We have another show that's just dedicated to conditional access, so take a look at that show. I also know that role-based access is an area where people have been really looking for what we're going to do there. What have we been doing?
So we've invested heavily into highly customizable roles and permissions. Not only can you define granular permissions, but you can also scope where a user can exercise those permissions. For example, here I've created a custom role just for help desk. And what I've done is I've given that role very limited permissions, limited set of device actions. And in fact, I've scoped this down so that they can only perform these actions against a specific group. In this case, this is my iOS devices. So now I can assign somebody this help desk role, and they can reset a device, reset passwords, but only for folks in that group and only on those set of devices.
So does this just work with device groups?
No, it works with all kinds of groups. A group is a group is a group. Any group that exists in your Active Directory, you could use. So you could use it based on region, you could base it on department, any way you want to slice it.
So those look like amazing investments in the UI. Have we done anything for folks that maybe prefer to automate everything?
Yeah, we absolutely have. So everything you see in the UI is exposed through the Microsoft Graph API. And because of this, you can script and automate a bunch of common tasks. So as an example, I can show you how we can leverage reporting and visualization using Power BI. So here I've built a dashboard in Power BI that's connected to Graph. It pulls information from Azure Active Directory, so I can see things like unfamiliar sign-ins. It pulls information from Intune, so I can see a breakdown of my devices by OS. I've got, on the right-hand side here, AD users, a breakdown of my operating systems from Intune as well. And then, of course, I've got a list of the number of users in my directory, and I can see things like how long devices check in for and when they check in. Now, a fairly common scenario is to show devices that haven't talked to a service in a while so that we can clean them up periodically. Now, I could do this manually in the UI, but it tends to be something I'm likely to do every month or so. So really, I've written a PowerShell script that automates this. So I just go into PowerShell, and it's going to connect to the service. It's going to pull all the information from Graph, find those devices that are old, and then go delete them from Intune.
This is great. This is a lot of stuff that people have been really asking for quite some time. How can these folks actually try these things?
So if you're already an Intune customer, it's most likely that your tenant has actually been provisioned. If not, you can expect it to be migrated pretty soon, and you'll see a link in top of Silverlight that takes you to the new portal. You can also follow the link below and actually create yourself a new trial tenant to go test these things out.
Craig, thanks very much for joining me today on Microsoft Mechanics, and thank you for watching, and don't forget to keep watching for the latest in tech updates. We'll see you next time.